I'm Smita Singh. I work for the European Union office in New Delhi and I'm managing the energy programs for the European Union.
According to you, what are your initial thoughts on the Scopic program?
Scopic project is a very ambitious project as per us. It is looking at setting up a solar and a biomass hybridization project in the state of Bihar. Considering Bihar is not a very, very advanced state and the need of power is felt everywhere as it is. But because it is the hub of the biomass availability, so the European Union kind of had let out call for proposals seeking interest from the Indian and European partners to come up with project concepts on where should such a hybridization be presented, a pilot project set up, and this was this was evaluated as one of the projects that the EU wanted to support. So yes, it is. We are looking forward to have some good results. This project has had some initial delays now in accessing land and. Some government approvals have taken long, but we are happy that the Bihar State Power Generation Corporation Limited is a active partner. They have finally come up with some land allocation, and once this power plant is up and running, it's going to become the property of the state. So we are very much looking forward to have a successful installation and testing of this hybridization technique.
So, can you share your experiences on the EU-funded energy projects?
EU-India Energy Cooperation has been on for a very long time, if I'm not wrong, since 2004. The European Union and the Indian government have been in touch through various policy dialogues, identifying areas such as clean energy, energy security, clean coal production as their areas of focus. And this project that we have now selected to support is a part of our development assistance program, and we are going to be happy. I mean, this is together with C-STEP and the other partners, Thermax, and with ECN and CNRS, that this team is coming together to bring in European and Indian experience. So Europe is very much, want to be partners with India and help them make clean India a reality and help them support clean energy production and see how solar, biomass, wind, all these areas could be harnessed. I mean, today India is doing a lot in solar, a lot in onshore wind. So the European Union is trying to support India in biomass and also in offshore wind opportunities.
Okay. What does the EU hope to achieve in supporting such projects?
I think the first thing is partnership and technology exchange, best practice exchange, learnings. Europe has been at the forefront of all these technologies over the past years. Be it solar, be it onshore wind, be it offshore wind. And through projects like the Scopic and our other projects that we have with the Government of India, the main aim is to bring European best practices and help the European companies come and become partners with India, collaborate with them and try to be here and support them, build capacity and share their learnings, which is in the interest of India, because then, we don't want everybody to do the same mistakes again and again.
What are the takeaways for the EU community from these projects?
The EU community, I think we look at it as a global action to promote renewable energy, to promote clean technologies around the world and help India meet up to the greenhouse gas emission reduction targets. So the EU community is actually wanting to become a global partner with India, and that's the line that we would like to take. At the industry-to-industry cooperation, we also see a lot of scope where companies could partner together, could bid for projects together. It could be in India, it could be out of India. So I think it could be a start of a new partnership, a new collaboration in the clean tech sectors, promoting energy cooperation.
Okay, thank you so much, Smita, for giving your time.